So welcome, Pennell, please.
Hi, everyone. My name is Kate. There was once who read the program expected another person. To be more specific, Alexander Kapitonov, the progressor of our team. Unfortunately, he didn't manage to come to Vancouver, so today I'm here to represent his report on robot economics, on Ethereum blockchain, task formulation, and proposed solutions. First of all, I'd like to share how we came to the idea of robot economics and what is it generally like. Robot economics is rather a new term, which appeared just last year. So there were at once several people who formulated it and published their results in books and scientific publications. Also, these publications gave information about great changes in the world because of robot integration to our life due to creating fully automated factories, which will make production cheaper. Financial flow will change as there will be nobody to pay taxes besides robots. So it will be necessary to create new, still unknown jobs. For now, we just don't know what will it be. But we must provide employment, of course. Trying to solve these problems, we are using two ways. So, Sergei Lanshakov, the chief executive officer of our team, a blockchain developer, chose programming approach. He used Ethereum blockchain in work. Formally, it's a decentralized database with virtual machine inside that allows to keep and run specific script, smart contract. Alexander Kapitonov tackled the problem from the academic side. He has been dealing with robotics since 2011 and presented his PhD thesis on industrial automation. Being between these approaches, the technical one, robotics, and the communication one, blockchain, we came to the idea that robots can become complete economical agents and make most part of routine decisions themselves. So, to check the possibilities of such a technology, we first chose drones. As a result, a man could make a transaction with a drone via smart contract in Ethereum blockchain. It's the first time where a human deal with formal smart contract. Due to this contract, the drone gets information about the route and the data that must be sent to the client after the flight. Herewith, the drone acts as an economical agent. Many economical autonomous agents, companies, machines, and services can be noticed in this smart contract, and all money and liabilities transferred to each other. We can see the first experience of making transaction with a drone using smart contract right now on the screen. The drone is getting GPS coordinates through the smart contract. You can see on the screen our developer, Alexander Kupenkin, who is now making a transaction with the drone, and right now it will fly. Yes. So, what will be the next step for us? To control robots by means of capital flow. We will not issue commands to robots. Instead of this, they will get commands estimating the situation in the market. Please pay attention at the scheme on the screen. Here is a standard scheme with feedback where capital flow is at the input. It is compared with market metrics and come to input of ERA. In the output, we get market demand. ERA is something like a controller for Industry 4.0 with fully automated factories. To demonstrate it, we chose a railroad, as it is usually associated with something industrial. This is some kind of a draft of a fully automated factory, a smart factory. The main problem talking about lights out manufacturing is how can a plant without people avoid becoming a bankrupt, as human needs change from time to time. So AeroLab intends to create responsive robot economics where fully automated factories are aware if human need change and meet new requirements. The train is a draft of such a manufacturing. There are two test markets now. The train is controlled by AeroLab, which follows the trends of these two markets. Those ones who have Air tokens can buy features either in the market A or the market B. So let's see how all of it works. We created a game for anyone who feels like trying how our idea works. As I already told you, there are two test markets in our game. So let's imagine that market A produces, for example, diesel fuel. And market B produces petrol. Right now, the latest futures purchase is at the higher price at the market A, and it means that it's more profitable. That's why the train is moving in the circle A. But let's imagine that scientists, for example, found out that diesel fuel is very harmful for environment and forbade to produce diesel cars. So investors start buying the futures of the market B, of the market which produces petrol, as it's getting more beneficial. You can see on the screen how to buy futures at our test markets and try to influence the train movement. AERA estimates the situation and sends information to a lights out manufacturing or to the train, as in our example. So as you can see, the train changed its movement. Now we are looking for a new partnership to work at the idea of robot economics and try our technologies on application examples. For today, we have a couple of academic partners from Poland, Italy, Latvia, Estonia, and of course Russia. ITMO University, Riga Technical University, Silesian Technical University in Poland, Innopolis, the University of Messina, and University of Technology. Together, we are developing common educational programs in this field, where you can, of course, take part, and also we are conducting research in robot economics. First publication will be presented in October at the conference Research, Education and Development of Unmanned Aerial System in Sweden. And the partners of ours, who already use the technology of AERA for solving their tasks. Air Care Insurance. These guys developing the technology for vehicle insurance and protocol effects in blockchain. Bold means this is a company which issues the digital counterpart of Bolt. Next, company integrates unmanned aircraft to business processes. They collect information about how much water and other housing services citizens use. The next one, Dow IPCI. This project is created to appeal to reduce CO2 discharge. The project IoT Open EU is developing educational disciplines in the field of decentralized Internet of Things, supported by the Erasmus Plus program. And Drone Employ, who organizes a supply chain for drone services using AERA technological stack. And now a little about our future. We decided to tell about us and arrange a tour all around the world. In October, we are going to Europe, to many different cities. In November, we will be in the USA, and we are going to finish our work here in Asia. So we will be very glad to meet you in any of these countries and or cities. So I know that this field is very new for many of these participants, and you possibly have really many questions, but unfortunately I have only 10 minutes for my speech, so I suggest you to call at exhibiting hall and come up to our stand. I will be waiting there for you to answer all of your questions. So thank you very much for your attention and bon appetit.
Thank you very much, Kate, and thank you to the Eric for their sponsorship.